And there's two correct answers here. The first one is that the size of this huge Boolean formula here is polynomial in n, and I will show you why. First of all, how large is each one of these formulas that we're building? Well, there's a constant number of variables, and as I showed you before, if you want to ensure that for a constant number of variables, only exactly one of them can be set to true, then the resulting formula is about the square of the number of variables that you have. And since we have a constant number of variables, each formula here is about the size of the square of that constant. So we have, it's kind of O of C squared. And C does not depend on the size of the input. So in a way, we can even write this as O of 1. Now we have a polynomial number of these Boolean formulas. So we have a polynomial of n times a constant. This is again a polynomial of n. So we're fine on this side here. We're also fine on this side here because the formulas again are of constant size. It can of course be a huge size, especially if you have a system that can carry very large variables. But nevertheless, it's a constant size, and that's all we care about. It does not depend on the size of the input. And we have a polynomial number of them again here. And finally, the code also has a constant number of lines. And so the Boolean formula resulting from that will also have constant size. So overall, this huge formula here has a size that is polynomial in n. Does this formula have only one satisfying assignment? No, it doesn't. It has a huge number of satisfying assignments, but each of those satisfying assignments will ensure that exactly one of the variables here is set to true, and so on. And this gives us the third property, which means that this satisfying assignment defines a snapshot because it will tell you exactly what's in this memory cell here, and so on. It will tell you exactly where the program is at, and it will also tell you exactly what's here in this memory. And once we have this, you have actually completed the most difficult step of this unit in my mind, and we are now ready to show that SAT is NP-complete.